Hey, second graders, this is Mrs. Lynch. I'm the math coach at Ridgeview Elementary. And today I'm here to do a math lesson with you. I know when you were in school and probably in your work at home now, you're working on adding and subtracting those bigger numbers to 100 and beyond. And our focus is to use those non-counting strategies. I know that you've been using models such as solving them mentally and then maybe showing your thinking on an open number line or with the arrow method, and you've also been using the place value model. Whichever model or strategy you're using, it's super important that you are using non-counting strategies. We're using what we know about our small facts to 10 and to 20, and those are an important basic foundation for you to do your higher addition and subtraction. So today we're going to be looking for efficient ways to group numbers and separate out equivalent expressions from each side of the equal sign. Algebra. Our activity is taken from Kathy Fosno's mini lessons for extending addition and subtraction. You're going to need a pencil and some papers. Go ahead and grab that now. All right, are you ready to begin? Let's get our math brains warmed up. Answer each question that I pose as quickly as you can. So if I'm at 32, how many from 32 to 40? Did you say 8? Nice. How many from 56 to 60? Did you say 4? Well done. How many from 63 to 70? I hope you said 7. How many from 78 to 80? Did you say 2? How many from 91 to 100? I bet you said 9. On all of these, we're thinking about our small facts to 10. We know that 1 plus 9 gets us to 10. So because we know that 91 plus 9 gets us to 100. All right, one more. How many from 25 to 30? Ah, that's an easy one. 5. Nice job. And how many from 47 to 50? I'm sure you said 3. Well done. Now, here's our last one. It's a challenge. How many from 94 to 110? Did you say 16? Nice. I bet some of you did it this way. Some of you may have said 94 plus 6 gets me to 100. Plus 10 gets me to 110. Some of you got to the even 10 first. Some of you might have made a jump of 10 first and said 94 plus 10 gets me to 104, and then adding 6 more gets me to 110. Nice job. All right, friends, now we're going to start our lesson for the day. And I want you to think about those small facts that you have, that knowledge that you have about those facts to 10 and those facts to 20. You have an amazing tool belt of strategies and knowledge that you've gained, and I want you to dig into that today. So we're going to start with our first problem right up here, 5 plus 5. And I want you to tell me, is that equation true or not true? Is 5 plus 5 the same as 10? I bet you instantly knew that that was true, because you looked and you saw 5 plus 5, easy fact, is the same as 10. Nice. All right, let's go on to this problem right here. 2 plus 6 plus 4 is the same as 4 plus 10. Is that true or not true? Did you say true? Good. I'm hoping that you saw some of the same things I did. I zeroed in on this 10 right here. And I went to the other side. I said, well, I see 10 right there. Those two 10s, in the algebra world, we say they cancel each other out. So they're the same. So we're balanced. And then my 2 and my 2 are also the same. So this equation is true. All right, here we go. Here's another one right here. 2 plus 3 plus 7 equals 9 plus 1 plus 2. True or not true? wondering what you shared with the people around you, if you have people, or what you said. Did you say it was true? When I looked at this problem, some things jumped out at me. 9 plus 1 jumped out at me, because I know that's 10. And 3 plus 7 jumped out of me, because I know that's 10. So those, both of those 10s balance out our equation. And then again, we have our 2 and our 2. Nice. All right, let's do another one right here. There's some more numbers in this one. I wonder if my strategy that you've seen in the first three is what you're using. 2 plus 8 plus 5 plus 5 is the same as 4 plus 10 plus 6. True or not true? So I'm wondering what you said out loud. Let's look and see. I saw a 10 right here. And I'm wondering if there's a 10 over on the other side over here. Oh, I see 5 plus 5. That jumped out at me. So those two 10s are the same. And then over here I have a 2 and an 8. Well, I know because of my facts to 10 that 2 plus 8 is 10. And I look on the other side and I say, oh, yeah, look at that. 4 and 6. Those make 10. So those balance each other out. So this equation is true. Did you solve all the way across here and then solve all the way across here and then compare your numbers? Or did you look for things that were equal expressions on each side of the equal sign? Try that on this last one. See if you can find some equal expressions that match up that we can cancel out. 3 plus 8 plus 7 equals 10 plus 5 plus 3. True or not true? What did you decide? Did you decide it was true or not true? Let's look and see what we found. I see an easy squeezy 10 plus 5. That jumps out at me, and I know that that is 15. And I'm wondering if there's a 15 on this side of the equation over here. Oh, I see an 8 plus 7. I know 8 plus 7 is 15 because I know my doubles. I know 8 plus 8 is 16, so one less would be 15. I also know that 7 plus 7 is 14, so one more would be 15. So I used a double plus or minus 1 strategy. Those are what we call our non-counting by 1 strategies. So I know 8 plus 7 is 15, so those two 15s cancel each other out. And now I see I have a 3 and a 3, and those are balanced. Nice. Friends, I think of these equations like a teeter-totter. If you've ever been on a teeter-totter, you know that you have to have the same size or weight person on the teeter-totter with you, or it doesn't work out. The teeter-totter goes up and down, up and down. And if one of the people on the teeter-totter weighs more than the other, it ends up looking like this. One person is on the ground, and the other person is high up in the air, and they can't make the teeter-totter go up and down. So I like to think of our equations like a teeter-totter. We need that balance in the middle so each side has the same value as the other side. But I'm noticing on all of these equations that each side doesn't look like the other side. The sides look different. One is 2 plus 3 plus 7, and the other one is 9 plus 1 plus 2, but they both have the value of 12. So in our equations, each side of the equal sign can look different, but we have to have the same value in order to use our equal sign. Let's go through them together and see what you found. See if you found the same ideas that I did, and if you had some of the same thinking I had. So the first one up here, 25 plus 4 equals 4 plus 10 plus 10 plus 5. Whew! Well, I see 25 over here, and I'm wondering if there's a 25 on the other side of the equal sign. So I'm going to go over there, and I see a 10 plus 10 plus 5. And I'm so good at my facts to 10 and 20 and beyond that I don't even have to think about those. I know that those both make 25. So those cancel each other out. They're balanced. And now I'm looking at my 4 and my 4, and those are balanced. So this first equation is true. Okay, let's go on to the next one. True or not true? What did you decide? This one, I kind of threw a curve in there. I put a minus sign. I put some subtraction in there. I wonder how that turned out. 10 plus 5 minus 5 equals 15 plus 3 plus 2. Well, I see a 15 here, and I see 15 over here. Well, looking good so far about being balanced. Looks true so far. And then I see 15 minus 5, and I see 15 plus 5. So my operation symbols change the game up a little bit. 15 minus 5 is 10, and 15 plus 5 is 20. So this equation is not true. The way we show an equation not true is to put a line through the equal sign. And that shows that it is not true. It's not equal. They are not balanced. If this were a teeter-totter, it would look like this. 20 down there and 10 up here, and there wouldn't be any fun being had. So, all right, let's go on to our next equation. 25 plus 6 plus 4 minus 6 is the same as 4 plus 15 plus 5 plus 5. Ooh, that's a lot of numbers. If you're just working from left to right, that's a lot of work. So I'm hoping you found some equal expressions, equivalent expressions. Let's look. Well, I see a 25 over here. And do I have a 25 on the other side? Well, I see 15 plus 5 is 20, and 5 more is 25. Well, there we have it. 25 and 25, those balance each other out. So far, so good. Let's keep looking. I have a 6 plus 4, which what do we know 6 plus 4 to be? Right. 6 plus 4 is 10. And then 10 minus 6. What's 10 minus 6? If that doesn't come to you quickly, you can think, what goes with 6 to make 10? Ah, 4. 10 minus 6 is 4. And 4 is the same as the 4 over here. So this equation is true. Whew, that took a little bit more math, a little bit more thinking. Good thing we got those 25s out of the way and we could just focus on that piece right there. All right, let's move on to our fourth problem here. 19 plus 6 plus 13 is the same as 20 plus 13 plus 5. What did you decide? Well, 19 is not a friendly number for me. So I'm going to go over here and I'm going to look at my 20 plus 13 plus 5. Well, I know that 20 plus 5 is 25. So I'm wondering if I've got a 25 here on the front side of this equation. 19 plus 6. Oh, I'm remembering my facts using a 9. 9 and 1 more makes 10. So 19 and 1 more makes 20, which leaves 5 left in my 6, and 20 plus 5 is 25. Oh, I have a 25 over here. Phew! And I have a 25 over here. That took a little more thinking, but I didn't count by ones. So those 25s cancel each other out. And now I have 13 left and 13 left. And those balance, if those were on the teeter-totter, they would be balanced. So this equation is true. All right, how you doing? You keeping up with me? I'm wondering if you had some of the same thinking I had. I sure hope so. Let's go on to our next one. 8 plus 8 plus 10 plus 5 is the same as 20 minus 4 plus 15. Well, I see a 15 here. Do I have a 15 on the other side? Yep, those jumped out at me right away. So I know those are balanced. We don't have to worry about those. Now I'm left with 8 plus 8 and 20 minus 4. Well, I know my doubles. I know 8 plus 8 is 16 because I'm really good at my doubles. And over here, 20 minus 4. Well, I know 10 minus 4 is 6. So 20 minus 4 is 16. Ah, look at that. 16 and 16 are balanced. So our teeter-totter is balanced. So this equation is true. Whew. Okay, here we go. Last one has a star by it. That means this is a challenge. Up over 100. So I see a 25 and a 50 and a 75, and those always make me think of quarters. I love quarters. And I'm looking over here at my 75. And I know 75 is 3/4. If I had change in my hand, 75 cents would be 3/4. And if I go over here, I have a quarter and 50 cents. I'm thinking money. And 50 cents is 2/4. And then we have a quarter here. So there's my 3/4. Oh, that is 75. So there we go. 25 plus 50 and 75 are the same. So those balance each other out. So now I have 100 and 100 plus 100. 100 plus 100 is 200. And I have 100, and those are not balanced. Our teeter-totter would look like this. So this equation is not true. Wow, that is a lot of thinking and a lot of math. And I hope that you were looking for equal expressions on each side of the equation that you could kind of cancel out with each other and not have to just work straight across doing the math here and then doing the math here, because that takes a lot of time. So now, friends, I'm going to leave you with an activity that you can do with your family. I want you to try some on your own. You, the amazing mathematician, are going to use all of your number knowledge within 100, and I want you to create some true and not true equations for your family to solve. You are going to create them. You can go back and look at the other ones that you did on your paper to give you an example of what it looks like. I want you to keep that teeter-totter in mind. Some of your equations should be able to be balanced and some not. And then see if you can get your family to figure out which one is true and which ones are not true. I want you to do 5, 6, maybe 10. You could do as many as you want, but I really want you to try this. Have some fun with it. And then please take a picture and share it with your teacher when you are done. Friends, it's been fun doing math with you today. I hope you enjoy this activity and just use your skills and be great, because I know you're all amazing mathematicians.